Hello everyone, first of all thanks for being here in my YouTube channel. Please give feedback to us for more number of electrical videos. Let's see the problem. A series circuit with a resistance of 10 ohm, inductance of 0.2 henry, capacitance of 40 microfarad is supplied with 100 volt supply 50 hertz. So supply is given 100 volt 50 hertz. So it's a series circuit. See here, R, L and C are connected in series. They mentioned in the question. So supply voltage is 100 volts 50 hertz. What is the value of R? R value is 10 ohm and L value is given 0.2 henry and then C value is given 40 microfarad, right? So what we need to find now? Current and power factor. I we need to calculate, power factor we need to calculate, power we need to calculate, right? So what is the formula for I? I is equal to what? V by Z. So Z we don't know, right? This is Z, okay? This is totally Z impedance. So Z is equal to root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. If it is XL is greater than XC, R. Z is equal to root of R square plus XC minus XL whole square. Right? So XC is greater than XL. XL is greater than XC, this one. So now we need to find XL and XC because directly we cannot take L and C. They have given inductance and then capacitance. We need to calculate inductive reactance now. So what is the formula for XL? XL is equal to 2 pi FL. So 2 pi into 50 into 0.2 henry. The answer is 62.83 ohm. Okay, use calculator properly. And next there is a XC. XC is equal to what? 1 by 2 pi FC. 1 divided by 2 pi into 50 into C is how much? 40 microfarad, 40 into 10 raised to minus 6. Finally, we got this one 79.57. So, XC is more compared to XL. We have to prefer this power formula. So, we can take both the formula because square root will be there. Definitely, we will get same value. What is the value of Z? Z is equal to root of R square is 10 square plus XC minus XL. So, 79.57. 79.57 minus XL is 62.83 square. Finally, Z is equal to 19.49. Okay. Now we can calculate I over here. I is equal to what? V is 100 divided by this 19.49. Finally, we got 5.138 amps. Okay. So now we need to calculate current over power and then power factor. Power factor we can calculate, right? Power factor is equal to cos phi is equal to R by Z formula. So R is how much? 10 divided by Z is 19.49. Finally, we got 0.513. Second one over. Okay. This is first one. Next, we need to calculate power. So third one is power. So power is equal to what? VI cos phi. So voltage is 100. Current is 5.13. Cos phi is how much? 0.513. Finally, power we got 263.21 watts. This is the answer. So, we'll cross-check the answer now. Okay. So, there is a resistance is given and then 2 pi FL, 62.83 we got and 71.57. So, finally, impedance of circuit is 19.49. I is equal to 5.130, right? Cos phi is equal to R by Z, 0.513 and power by control circuit is 263.21. Next problem, a voltage of V is equal to 100 sin 3140 is applied to a circuit consisting of 25 ohm resistance and 80 microfarad capacitor in series. Definitely it's a RC series circuit, right? So connected across AC supply, that is in the format V is equal to Vm sin omega t, right? So V is equal to 100 sin omega is 314 t, right? R is given 25 ohm, C is given 80 microfarad, right? So what we need to calculate? Peak value of current. So peak value is maximum value of current, that is Im, right? And power factor and power we need to calculate, right? So what is the formula for Im? Im is equal to Vm by Z, right? So Z we need to calculate. So with this one I take Z, okay, Z. What is the value of Z? Z is equal to R minus JXC. So R is given 25 minus JXC is not given, C is given. So we need to find out XC now. XC is equal to what? XC is equal to 1 by 2πfc. So 1 by 2 pi, frequency is not given, right? Omega is given. So omega is equal to 2 pi f, f is equal to omega by 2 pi, you will get 50 hertz, okay? Into 50 into c is 80 into 10 raised to minus 6. So finally, we got xc is equal to 39.80 ohm, okay? Xc we got. So the value I'll substitute over here. 39.80. So what about Im? Im is equal to, I'll be converting this one into polar form. So we'll get by using calculator 47 angle minus 57.08 degree. Okay. So Im is equal to Vm is 100 divided by this one is 47. Okay, 47. So how much will get it? So Im is equal to 2.1276 amps. Okay. Next we need to calculate the power factor. Cos phi is equal to what? R divided by Z. So Z is how much? Z is this value. So R is how much? 25 divided by 47. We got 0.5319. Okay. 19. Next, there is a power. Power is equal to what? Vi cos phi. We'll cross check once again. So, Vm is omega is given. So, finally, we got x is equal to 31.80. Z is equal to this value. So, I converted into this one. And Vm is equal to this value. And cos phi is equal to R by 0.53. Power is equal to Vi cos phi. See here, Vm by root 2, Im by root 2 cos phi. So, V is Vrms, Irms cos phi. Okay. So, finally, we got 56.58. Next problem, two impedances Z1 and Z2 are connected in parallel and current flowing through this combination is 20 plus J10 amps, right? That is I. So voltage they are not given, right? So we need to find, I guess. So Z1 is what? 6 minus J8 and then Z2 is what? 16 plus J12. So what we need to find? Find the voltage across the combination and current in the two branches. This I1 we need to calculate, I2 we need to calculate. So, what is the formula for voltage? Voltage is equal to I into Z equivalent, right? I is given, we need to calculate Z equivalent now. So, what about I1 current? Because parallel circuit voltage must be same. So, if you calculate once voltage, you can take I1 is equal to V by Z1, I2 is equal to V by Z2, right? So, Z equivalent we need to calculate. What is the formula for Z equivalent? These two are in parallel. Z1 into Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. I'll substitute the values now. So Z1 is 6 minus J8 into 16 plus J12 divided by 6 minus J8 plus 16 plus J12. Use calculator properly, put bracket. So we will get Z equivalent is equal to 8 minus J4 or 8 minus 4A after calculating this one by using calculator. Okay. If you convert this into polar form, the root of 8 square plus 4 square, 5 is equal to tan inverse of 4 by minus 4 by 8. Okay. By 8. Finally, we will get this one is 8.9445. Angle minus 26.57 okay, degree. No need of this calculation, conversion of these values. Directly you can put 8 minus J4. So V is equal to what? I is 20 plus J10 into 8 minus J4. So finally we will get 200 plus J0. So voltage is 200 volts. Okay, here 200. Okay, how to calculate I1 now? I1 is equal to V by Z1, 200 divided by 6 minus J8 and I2 is equal to 200 divided by 16 plus J12. Finally, the answer is, this one is 200 divided by 6 minus J8. This is This is 12 plus 16 J, and this one is 8 minus J6. If you want to convert into polar form, you will get 10 angle minus 53.13. This one will get 10 angle minus 36.86. Any one answer you can put it in your examination. Okay, this is your answer. See here, 20 plus J10, 12 plus 8, you will get 20. J16 minus J6, definitely you will get J10M. Then your column is correct. Okay. Likewise, you can cross check the answer. So you can convert into a rectangular to polar and polar to rectangle by using calculator. Okay. Power is equal to Vm by root 2, Im by root 2. This RMS value, power is equal to V cos phi. So cos phi, that is Vm is 100 by root 2 into Im is how much? Im is 2.127, 2.1212 divided by root 2, cos phi is 0.539. Finally, we got 56.58 watts. Okay, this is a problem. Use calculator properly, you get answer. Once again, cross check the answer. So, I is 20 plus J10 is given. So, I converted into a polar form this value. And then Z equivalent is Z1 into Z2 into Z1 plus Z2. So Z total is, so see, this is a mistake actually. You should not write like this, because here angle you have mentioned, here also it should be angle. Okay. Then if you calculate like this, definitely you will get different answer. So don't do the mistakes like this. So we will get, this is okay. This is converted and then they have done. So finally we got 85.94 minus 26.57. So V is equal to I into ZT. So we got, this you just to multiply this one and this one, you will get 200 angle 0, and then I1 is equal to this value, I2 is equal to this value. Next problem, two impedances Z1 and Z2 are connected in parallel. Right? The supply current is for this circuit is 15 amps. Voltage is not given. What we need to find? Power. Right? Power we need to calculate in each branch. Right? P1 is equal to what? I1 square R1. P2 is equal to I2 square R2. Only in resistance part, power will be dissipated. So Z1 is equal to what? 10 plus 15 J15, and then Z2 is equal to 6 minus J8, right? So I will be assuming Z1 is equal to R plus JXL for this branch. This one Z2 is equal to R minus JXE for this branch, okay? So what we need to find? I1 and I2 we need to calculate, right? So R1 is given, 10, and then 6 is R2. So I1 and I2 calculation, we are having two ways. One is I1 is equal to V by Z1, I2 is equal to V by Z2. You can calculate this voltage, right? V is equal to I into Z equivalent. You can calculate Z equivalent and then you can multiply the current, you'll get total voltage, this voltage. This is one method. So I'll be using this method. So I1 is equal to total current into opposite branch impedance Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. So what is I? 15 amps. Total current is given 15 amps. Into Z2 is 6 minus J8 divided by Z1 plus Z2. 10 plus J15 plus 6 minus J8. So calculate properly by using calculator. Okay. You will get answer as 1.96 minus J8.36. If you want to calculate in polar form, polar is equal to there is an answer like 8.58 angle minus 76.75. This is the answer. Okay, this is the current. I mean, this one is magnitude. Next, there is a I2 is equal to total current into opposite impedance divided by total sum of the impedances. So, Z2. So, I is 15 amps into opposite impedance is 10 plus J15 divided by Z1 is 10 plus J15 plus 6 minus J8. Right. So use calculator. I2 is equal to, finally we got 13.03 plus J8.36. Okay. So if you convert into power form, we will get 15.48 angle 32.36 6, 8. Okay, now we can calculate the power, right? So power is equal to I1 square R1. So this 8.58, you have to take 8.58 square, only magnitude, into R1 is 10. We'll get 737 watts, and I2 is equal to this part, 15.48 square into 6. We'll get 1438 watts. This is how we are solving the problem. Here, see, power is equal to I square Y. I used only power distributed in resistance part, not inductive reactance and capacitor reactance, right? We'll cross check the answer. I is given 15 amps. That equivalent is calculated. And then V is equal to I into Z equivalent. I1 is equal to V by Z1. I2 is equal to V by Z2. P1 is equal to I1 square R and P2 is equal to I2 square R. Likewise, also, we can solve the problem. Both the methods are same.